Welcome to part two of the Ina to Z crochet along. I'm Polly Plum, your host and designer of this pattern. In part two, we're going to make the second and third triangles of our blanket. Now, I know that this is twice as much work as last week, but I also know how addicting this pattern is. So I think you can do it. And if not, don't worry, nobody's timing you and the pattern's not going anywhere. Also, side two and side three are made exactly the same, so it made sense to assign them at the same time. Now, grab your yarn and your hook, and let's take a look at what we're going to be making. As you make side two, it's going to be joined to side one, which is shown here, grayed out. The join is going to happen along the straight side of side two and the final row of side one. Side 3 is going to be made in the exact same manner, but it will be joined to side 2. Alright, now let's get started. We're going to start by making a slip stitch into the top of the very last treble of side 1. Okay, so here's your top of side 1, your last row of stitches, and the last stitch you made was this treble. Slip stitch with your new yarn into the top of that treble. This is just to join our yarn. This is where we're starting. Okay. And now chain two. Okay. Now we're going to work. This is going to feel kind of backwards. Counting backwards on the top of the last row of side one. So counting backwards, we're going to go skip the stitch just before the treble and the stitch before that. That's the one we're going to slip stitch into now. Okay, so we slip stitched into the treble. We're going to skip the stitch right before it and slip stitch into the stitch before that. It's the one before the front post extended double crochet. So not the front post double, but the double right after it. Okay, so slip stitch into that. And this is kind of an awkward angle to do this at, but don't worry, it gets easier for future rows. Okay, and this is gonna look kind of weird. That's okay. It's all gonna blend in when everything is joined up, okay? Okay, so that awkward little thing we did right there counts as your first double crochet. Now what I want you to do, I want you to make another double crochet into the treble. The very first place we put our first slip stitch, the top of that treble, make a double crochet right into there. And then in the same spot, make a treble. Okay? And that counts as row one. Now in row two, we're going to turn our work over first and then chain four. And in that very first stitch, make two double crochets. And in the next stitch, make a double crochet. Okay, now in the last stitch is this chain two and slip stitch that we made that joined to side one. In the top of that stitch, we're going to make a double crochet, but as we make it, we're going to join it to side one. Okay, so let me show you how to do that. Yarn over and insert your hook into the top of the last stitch. Now that is, it's kind of going to be kind of hard to tell what the top is. So just find a couple loops that look like the top, because again, in this join, everything is just going to kind of blend together. You're not going to see it. So I can see two loops here that look like the top of my slip stitch. I'm going to slip my hook under them, yarn over and pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through two loops. And now before you complete your double crochet, what we're going to do is join it to side one. So find the next two available stitches of side one. The next stitch after the join from the last row, or the stitch from the join from the last row is right here. And right after that, the top two loops of that stitch are the front post extended double crochet. The stitch after that is where we're going to join, okay? So there's the joined stitch, there's a stitch we're going to skip, and then the double crochet after that. We're going to insert our hook into the top two loops of that double crochet, yarn over, pull the loop through, and then pull that loop through the last two loops on our hook to close off our double crochet. So that is row two. Okay, now for row three of side two, before we turn our work over, we're going to do our first stitch. The reason is it's just a little easier to work it this way than to do the turn first. So the first thing I want you to do is chain two. And again, we're going to skip the next open stitch of side one and into the stitch after that, we're going to make a slip stitch. Okay, and that counts as your first double crochet. Now, turn your work around and we can continue working row three. So into the first stitch, which is this one right here, the join DC. Just go ahead and skip that one because technically we already have a double crochet coming out of it. That chain two and slip stitch count as our double crochet. And into the second stitch, make a double crochet. Then make another double crochet into the third stitch. And this is where things are going to start looking a lot more like side one. Now we're going to make a front post extended double crochet around this last double crochet before the treble, before the chain four that counts as a treble. So second to last stitch, make a front post extended double crochet around it. And then into the top of that chain four, two double crochets and a treble. Okay, and that is side three. Okay, side two, row four. We're going to turn our work and chain four to count as our first treble, and then two double crochet in that first stitch. Now we're going to do a double crochet in each of the next two stitches. And that brings us to the front post extended double crochet that you can see more on the other side. We're going to make a back post extended double crochet around that. Now double crochet in the next two stitches. And into that last stitch, the first stitch of row three, the chain two and slip stitch, we are going to make our join double crochet. So yarn over, and again, it can be odd looking because the yarn gets twisted, there's a slip stitch, so just do your best. I like to kind of use my hook to pull some yarn over so that I can see the top two loops a little better. Insert your hook to the top, pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through two loops. Now skip the next stitch of side one and into the stitch after that, insert your hook, pull up a loop, and pull that loop through the two loops that were on your hook already. And there you go, there's your joined double crochet to side one. And that is row four. So by now you are probably getting the picture that all the rows we're making are just like side one, except that we are joining along this side as we make them. So for row five, we're going to do the same thing we did for row three. We're going to chain two before we turn, chain two, skip the next open stitch of side one, and into the next stitch of side one, the top two loops, make a slip stitch. And there, that counts as your first double crochet of row five. Now we can turn our work and not into the first stitch, into the second stitch, make a double crochet. Into the third stitch, make a double crochet. The next stitch is the back post extended double crochet. We're going to make a front post extended double crochet around it. Then we're going to make three double crochets. One, two, and three. Now we should have just two stitches left. Around the next stitch, make a front post extended double crochet. And then the last stitch is the chain four that counts as a treble. Make two double crochets and a treble into that stitch. And that is row five. Okay, just like in side one, row six of side two is important because this is one of the rows that you're going to repeat to make your blanket. So first we're going to turn our piece over and chain four, two double crochet in that first stitch, double crochet in each of the next two stitches, that brings us to our front post extended double crochet. We make a back post extended double crochet around that. Oops. And then double crochet in each of the next three stitches. And that's the part we're going to repeat all the way across the side. Okay, so for row six, we're just going to make it twice, but in, you know, it's going to grow each time you do it. So the next repeat, back post, extended double crochet, and then three double crochets. The trick is, the very last double crochet of the row, you're going to join. So here we are again at the first stitch that doesn't look much like a stitch from a row five. So I'm just going to try and find the top two loops as best I can, insert my hook under them, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two loops. Now look at side one, skip the next stitch of side one and into the stitch after that, insert my hook, pull up a loop and pull that loop through the two loops that were already there. And that is row six joined up. Okay, now row seven of side two, I'm about to demonstrate for you, but I'm also going to show you what to do when you get to the end of your side one. You're going to do it just like the rest of the joins. You're just going to find that top chain of the chain three that counts as the double crochet that's here on the corner, okay? So for row seven, we chain two, skip that next stitch of row one, and in that very last stitch there, or the next stitch, you know, depending on where you're at on your side, insert your hook into the top of the chain three if you're at the end, and slip stitch. Then you can turn. Skip that very first stitch, into the second stitch, make a double crochet. Into the third stitch, make a double crochet. All right, now here's our repeat. Make a front post extended double crochet and then three double crochets all the way across until you just have two stitches left. Another front post extended double and then three double crochets for the repeat. One, two, three. All right, now you should have just two stitches left at the end. You're going to make a front post extended double crochet around the second to last stitch. And in the very last stitch, the top of the chain four, two double crochets and a treble. And that's row seven. So now to complete side two, what you're going to do is just repeat row six and row seven as many times as you need to get to the end of side one. If you do this properly, you will have the exact same amount of rows in side two as you did for side one, okay? That's very important. Otherwise, side two will be bigger and your square won't be square when you're done, okay? So repeat row six and row seven until you have made it to the end of side one, and then fasten off. To make side three, follow the instructions for side two. Take your piece, turn it like this, You'll start down here at the very last treble at the end of side two, and make side three exactly like you did for side two. You'll just be joining to side two, and your rows will get worked up like this to the end of side two, and it will look like this. That's it for this part of our crochet along. Thank you so much for crocheting along with me, and I will see you next week for part three. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video tutorial, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Every Trick on the Hook, or follow me on Facebook, also Every Trick on the Hook. Subscribe to my blog, everytrickonthehook.com, or you can follow me on Instagram. I'm actually Polly Plum on Instagram. And best yet, join the Facebook group, the Polly Plum Pattern Posse, where you can get lots of help and support, and it's just a great place to share pictures of what you made. Thanks a lot. See you next time.